Hey, welcome to my channel, Spiritual Infusion 1111. So let's just go ahead and get into it. This is your divine partner. This is the current energy with your relationship. So starting off, we have 5, 7, and 9. This person is feeling at odds with you. First of all, they don't feel like they're on even ground. This is an energy where I feel like your person has had to really take a deep dive into their psyche, into their mental, about what's going on, to have a higher perspective as to why they're having all of these conflicts and all of this tension and all of these struggles. I'm getting with Slingshot here, there's a lot of tension in your relationship. There's tension because this person continues to push boundaries. There's tension because this person has to do the right thing and they always do the wrong thing, right? And I get that with this person, they're being pulled in a lot of directions. However, they're being forced to change right now. There's change that's being set into motion. And I feel like you're going to be receiving some type of confirmation or some type of communication from your person within a couple of days here, or you're going to see the situation begin to really unfold. And that's because they're getting ready to extend themselves. They're getting ready to provide you with a sense of clarity. This person has had a lot of time to reflect. This person has had this time to figure out what do they need to do in order to improve in the situation or in the connection with you. When it comes to your person, I feel like this is somebody that likes how people view them. This is somebody who may be dealing with somebody who looks good on paper, where everything about this person looks like they have the ideal lifestyle, like they're happy, like they have abundance. And the reality is, this person, they may have everything, but they're missing something from their life. They're missing the one thing that really makes life worth living. And I feel like that's true partnership. And with this person, I get overwhelmingly that whoever they were with, I feel like they had a relationship, or you may have even had a relationship with this person where it was open. There wasn't any type of defined roles. This is a relationship that started off as an emotional love affair where you may have fallen in love with somebody that was already attached to somebody else, which is why this connection is so hard to resist, because it's an emotional one. It's one at a soul level. And believe it or not, with this person, they've become codependent on your energy. They've become codependent on speaking to you, on hearing from you, on knowing that you're there. And I feel like with this partner, they're realizing that they can't change how they feel about you. Because this person feels like you and them are meant to be. They feel like you and this person are soulmates. I do get, though, with you, it doesn't make sense. There's something here where this person doesn't understand why you want them. Why do you love me? What about me? But the one thing they do understand is that this is a sacred bond that they need to protect. Right? There is something about this energy where this person knows that it's special. They know that there's something very significant about the way that you carry yourself, about the way that you handle yourself. This person understands that there's something here with you and them where it is a level of fulfillment, a level of intimacy, a level of sensual pleasures that they've never felt before. You and this person may even like astral travel towards one another at night. And I get that with this person, it's like they feel like they can have everything with you. Things can move very, very smoothly with you. However, it's like there's always something that's stopping. There's always this boat that stops them from progressing. They stop themselves with this on again, off again type of energy. They disappear. Things could be smooth if they allowed it to be. But the problem is with this person, they have a lot of people around them. They have a lot of people around them that are telling them certain things. People are giving them mixed signals. They're giving you mixed signals. for some of you guys, this person has been talking to people about you and they've said to them, like, they don't really care about you like that. It's all fake. Like, you don't have enough. You guys are too different. You guys are opposites. You have all these choices. Why would you want to settle down? The craziest thing, though, is it's like, no matter how much time goes in between you and this person, you still love this person. And they still love you very, very much. And I do feel like for some of you guys, you are in a love triangle. Whether this love triangle is with you, this person, and their work. Whether this love triangle is you, this person, and this other person who I feel like they're in an open relationship with. It's causing a lot of heartache because you're waiting for this person to pick you because they have this emotional affair, right? Because they have this codependency with you where you are this person's soulmate. But this is a situation that's not as easy to escape. I feel like this is a situation that's relatively challenging because whoever they're dealing with, it's very toxic. This person that they're dealing with is toxic. This person brings out the worst in them. This is somebody that affects them on a daily or a consistent, constant basis. This is somebody that knows a lot about this person, that may have even been with this person before you. I also get that with your person, I don't feel like they're having sex or any type of intimacy when it comes to this karmic connection. And I feel like with this person, it's like they don't, that situation with them is complicated. They're either tied to their finances, there's children involved, there's something with their inside of their family. There's something here where, like I just heard, it's a family affair. So when this person goes to try to leave them, somebody in their family, their extended family or whatever, comes back and tries to like get them in place. Whoever this karmic energy is, whoever this energy is that's in this love triangle with you, they're using all resources right now in order to keep you and your person apart, even if that's involving other people, even if that's making things complicated for them with their job, with their finances, whatever it is. It's creating a lot of tension, especially because this person is not being intimate with this karmic. You want to know why? Because God said no. Mm-mm. No more sleeping with the devil, right? I said this one time to somebody. See, with women get crazy when they sleep with somebody and then that person sleeps with other people and then comes back and sleeps with them because they're taking all those demons, that person's that other party's demons, and they're putting it inside of you. Then they want to know why you act crazy. Well, you act crazy because you know your body senses that there's a different energy. Your body senses a level of toxicity that's coming with that person. That's why they call it that devil dick, right? It's because they're in multiple people and you're bringing on all of those attachments. That's why they say when it comes to being intimate, you're supposed to be very careful with who you're intimate with, especially as a feminine energy. But the universe is saying this is a sacred bond. I don't care how complicated it is. I don't care how toxic this is. I don't care how off and on it is. This is something that's protected because you and this person have a specific path that you're meant to complete together. You and this person have this potential of having this happily ever after where you're stepping in to a future that's like one that could be written in a book. This is a fairy tale romance. Two opposites, two people that started off that had no idea the impact that would happen with just a single message, just a single friendship. No one could have ever guessed that this is how this relationship would have gone. And this is a romance that's very magical. There's a lot of magic behind it because this is a blessed bond. This is a blessed union by the universe, by your ancestors. There's an agreement. There is a partnership, a soul agreement, a contract where you and this person have already been promised to one another because there's so much good that you and them are here to do. for some of you guys, this is about creating. For some of you guys do something with the community. Like, there's nonprofits that are happening. You and this person are meant to impact the world on a global type of energy. And the both of you guys are needed together. And it's this fairy tale romance where it's like the moment that you and this person get together, everything starts to bloom. You understand why it never worked out with anybody else. And this person is going to see things differently. This person is going to realize that there's something much, much different about you. And this is a relationship that's here for the long haul. This is a relationship that's here, that's meant to love, that's meant to last. Because the both of you are willing to go through this journey together. Both of you don't know where you're going. The outcome is unknown. Look, the outcome is unknown. Nonetheless, there's this level of infatuation when it comes to this love. The love by you, the love by this person, where somebody is falling very, very fast. Because they're obsessed. They realize that they got caught up in the optical illusion that is life, right? Because if you are somebody where you're very shallow, you feel like money, wealth, power, prestige, that's what's important, right? But in the big scheme of things, people always feel like you get power by being cruel. There's a lot of power that comes by being good. There's a lot of power that comes by doing the right thing. By doing the right thing for everybody involved. And I feel like with this person, for some of you guys, they're getting ready to ask you to marry them. They're getting ready to take this relationship to the next phase, because I think that having this separation between the two of you, it's really, really challenging. You've allowed them to transition into this person that I don't think that they ever thought that it would be, because I think with you and them, it's always been a secret. But here's what's crazy. Even behind closed doors, your person has always put you on a pedestal. Your person has always treated you like royalty to others. This person has always spoken very highly of you. They've always talked about you in such a high light, because you give them this energy where you guys are working together. You guys are working as a team. You're not working against one another. You both have the same mission. And I also feel like for the two of you guys, it's almost like even if you guys are not physically together, you may feel like you feel like you're meant to be, but there's always something that's in the way, whether it's divine timing, whether it's a person, whether it's a place, whatever it may be. It's like you feel like there's something that's always working against this connection. And you're right. It is, right? When you have a connection like this, where there's so much good that's to be done with inside of this connection, any type of negative energy, low vibrational people, places, things, devil energy, whatever it may be, they don't like the light. And what's crazy about your connection is the fact that it is protected. This sacred bond is protected. Your person feels obligated to protect you. Your person feels obligated to do the right thing, to make sure that nobody is here to harm or hurt you. There is a level of possessiveness when it comes to your person. The idea with you being with anybody else devastates them. But what they're not understanding is that they're not protecting your heart. That's what needs protecting. Right? You need them to do this shadow work. You need them to do this shadow work so that the two of you can come together and be this very beautiful power couple. Because that's what's coming forward. There is a wish here that is coming true. But this had to do with timing. Right? A lot of this are past life issues that this person had to figure out. That's why you and this person had this rocky start, because of this person's life. The way that they were going about it, the way that they were doing things, it wasn't healthy. What messages do you have for the divine when it comes to their divine counterpart? What messages do you have for the divine when it comes to their divine counterpart? Sorry, my dog's next to me snoring. Prepare. This person is ready to fix what they've broken. See, the problem with this person is they have a lot of pride and ego. And this person's legacy is important to them, but also how you view them is important to them. The idea that you view them in a negative light, it upsets them, it hurts them. They know that they have to change the way that they're doing things. They understand, like right now, like they feel that you may not understand what's really going against them. And they're trying to be very careful right now because they don't want to do something or say something that's going to make you say, I'm good. This is something where this person feels like they need to make it right, that they need to restore the balance back into the connection because you've been the one giving. This is also a situation with this person. I feel like they've been working on fixing things for a period of time. You may not know that they've been working on it. They've been very concentrated. They're trying to draw out the toxicity and they're trying to purify their energy. And right now they are really, really worried. They're worried that it's gonna be too late. They're worried that it's too much time that's passed. They're worried that, you know, they're unable to de-escalate the situation. This is somebody that's very nervous. You wanna know why they're nervous? Because their life right now is one big mess. They have problems right and left. This is complicated. This is something where this person may even come to you and say, I'm trying to fix it, but I just need a little bit more time. Please, just give me a minute. This is something where this person's life has come out of control. Because they've had this energy of, it's my way or the highway. This is somebody that had an energy of, I do what I want when I want. This is somebody who felt like it was their way or you don't like it, too bad. They had this very egotistical energy where they felt like all they needed was them. They don't need anybody else. But now they're realizing that them doing things alone, it's really their own energy. They've created this mess. They've realized it. What do you want me to tell them? See, but I feel like your person is going through this major awakening. This person is curious about you, right? It's time. This person knows it's time. They've heard the spiritual awakening. They're curious. They're going from this dark to light. They're going down this rabbit hole. They don't know why they're going or where they're doing it or how they're getting there, but they're going regardless. They're determined to succeed. They're determined to be able to say, I did this, to say, I'm the king of this mountain. I'm the one that's done this, right? They're determined to make it right. They're determined to set the scales back to where they become. Because I feel like with this person, they're tired of avoiding you. They're tired of avoiding. They're tired of refusing to face reality. They're tired of pretending. They're tired of having this fear-based way of thinking where when things go bad, all they do is bury their head and pretend like it's not happening. It's happening. This person is beginning to realize that things that people were saying, they were doing it in order for a sense of control. And now with this person, they want to roll the dice. They want to take this risk. They want to see whether or not this is something that's worth it. They don't know what the outcome is here, though. This is somebody that feels like I'm willing to gamble and risk it all for you. To be loyal to you. To be faithful. To have this fidelity, this commitment, this trust. This person wants you as their support system. They want you to know that you can depend on them. That they are here for you if you need anything. This is a declaration. This person is ready to express to you, to reclaim their power. This person is ready to write you something, to say to you something, to be honest, to say, this is who I am. Either take me or leave me, but this is it. Liberty or death. They can't continue to live the way that they used to live. It just doesn't work for them anymore. They've had this spiritual awakening, this soul activation by you, where the way that they did things, it no longer fits. It no longer works, right? Because they're ready for partnership. You and them think alike. You're their partner in crime. This person is realizing that you are connected to them. You are their soulmate. There's contracts and agreements and bonds here. And this is a bond that cannot be broken. This is something with this person where it's happening very soon. For some of you guys, this person has purchased wedding rings. This person has been researching. This person is ready to sacrifice something in order to make you this strong offer. Because for the first time in a very long time, this person has made a decision. They're ready to make you an offer that they hope you're going to accept. It's an offer that's fair. They understand that you are going to judge them, but they also feel like it's going to make things much, much easier because this is an important decision and that you need to have the entire scope of what's going on in order for you to make an educated choice, in order for you to make an educated decision here. Nonetheless, it's a decision that involves partnership, that involves stability, that involves love. So, this is your divine counterpart reading. I love you guys so much. Thank you for all of your love and support. Please make sure you subscribe to my channel. And I just want to leave you with this: heart and home. Get ready. Some of you guys may be moving in with this person. You may be starting a family with this person, but there is a major legacy that you and this person are meant to fulfill together. And this is something, okay? Let me show you guys this. This is something, oops, sorry, I just bumped it. That's happening now. This is something that's happening soon. Peace.